नित्यानंदेश्वर सदाशिव समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरि आदिशक्ति मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरा। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, sarvangyapita yajamans, kotaris, thanedars, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, YouTube Live, two-way video conferencing, Facebook Live through hundreds of Adinavasis IDs. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today's subject, manifesting Shaktis. Understand, first principle you need to know about manifesting Shaktis is it happens from Sadashivatva, it can never feed your ego. Understand? It happens from Sadashivatva. It cannot feed your ego. Manidan manida maamisathai undu vaala mudiyadu. Human being cannot eat human flesh and survive. Understand? Yesterday I was reading a book called Agathiyar Karukkidai Nigandu. The statement now I uttered is from that Nigandu. Agathiyar Karukkidai Nigandu. Manidan, manida maamisam undu vaala iyaladu. Human being cannot survive with the flesh of human being. Maybe Agastya want to say should not. Listen, human body cannot flourish with human eating human flesh. Your ego cannot flourish with manifesting powers. One of the important problem we have, people feel, oh, if I get powers, will I not become egoistic? Or people who get powers, will they not become egoistic? No. Because it comes from the source of Sadashiva, where naturally your ego loses its power over you. The more power manifestation, more divine you become. Understand? Shakti comes with buddhi. Only siddhi comes without buddhi. Shakti is mother, siddhi is stepmother. That is why in Tamil, for stepmother and siddhi, both same word. Siddhi is chitti. Shakti is mother. Understand first principle about manifesting powers. It will not strengthen your ego, it will only take you beyond ego. First. Second, manifesting powers means manifesting qualities, state and space of Sadashiva also. Understand? When you manifest powers, naturally the state of Sadashiva and space of Sadashiva starts manifesting in you. I have always seen people who manifest powers have a very high level of integrity and unclutching, because if they do not maintain that too, the power manifestation will stop. Understand? How much ever you would have paid to buy your cell phone, but unless you charge every day, it will not function. How much ever you may manifest powers, unless the integrity of your life is maintained, it will not manifest. Actually, when you manifest powers, automatically the frequency of your integrity increases. The trust in integrity, trust in authenticity starts increasing. The reasons why you don't live a life of integrity is powerlessness. That starts melting down. With more and more power manifestation, powerlessness goes away. You become more integrated, more authentic. The second principle of power manifestation, listen carefully. Shakti comes always with buddhi. Means more power manifestation, more integrity. More power manifestation, more unclutching. More power manifestation, more nirvikalpa samadhi. More power manifestation, more joy. More power manifestation, more restful awareness. More power manifestation, more responsibilism. More power manifestation, more enriching. More power manifestation, more bliss. What is power manifestation? Deciding. Listen. Integrity needs your declaration. But power manifestation does not even need your declaration. It only needs your decision. Deciding to be one with the original source, Sadashiva, which is you, even when you don't understand. He was using very few words. That is his beauty. Just with few words, he will make that click happen. You know. First he was trying to tell, that everything is one. Few words. Somehow I was looking at him. He was not convinced that the click has happened in me. And many times both my gurus, Kuppammal and Mibudananda Puri and Yogananda Puri, both have tried to explain Advaita to me. Annamalai Swamigal even used to read out Ribu Gita. Annamalai Swamigal was one of the enlightened disciple of Ramana Maharshi, used to read Ribu Gita in Tamil. But somehow that click never happened. But just with few words, Arunagiri Ishwara made that click happen. Listen carefully. I'll explain scene by scene. If you listen intensely, now that click can happen to you. Now that very click can happen to you. Listen. Scene by scene, I'll narrate. Because clicking with Advaita is a fundamental requirement for power manifestation. Clicking with Advaita is fundamental requirement for power manifestation. So listen. The incident itself is not too big, but it has done a very big job inside me. So I'll narrate exactly what happened. So the moment he started uttering the word Advaita, 2-3 words, then, Yogananda Puri used to say, Vibhudananda Puri used to say, and Annamalai Swami used to say, Advaita, everything is one and the same. Okay, everything is one and the same. Understand? At that time, all their words, it's not that I did not believe them, but it never became my strategy for existence. It never became my cognition of existence. Okay, gurus are telling I should listen, I should obey, I should not be opposing them. But for my life, I have a different strategy. That is not the cognitive reality for me, on which I stand, the foundation on which I function, or foundation on which I make decision. It never became that for me. The foundation on which I make my decisions was always different. Even though I heard enough of Advaita from Yogananda Puri, Vibhudananda Puri, Annamalai Swamigal. So the moment Arunagiri Yogeshwara started, Advaita, immediately my old, this old, same thing, okay. Advaita, I know. All one and the same. I should tell you, whenever you listen and do not make that into cognition, it becomes incompletion. Great truths, when you listen, either it should become cognition or it will become incompletion. Food, when you eat, either it should become energy or it will become indigestion or constipation. So the moment Arunagiri Yogeshwara uttered the word Advaita, my constipation comes out. Incompletion comes out. I know. All one and the same. Listen. Now, frame by frame. He was sitting, facing north. I was sitting next the down step. He was actually sitting in the steps of that Thiruvannamalai Arunachaleshwara's temple, Kalyana Mandapam, facing his samadhi. His samadhi mandapam is there. So on the steps he was sitting facing north. You can see the photograph, exactly the place. I am sitting in the center. He was sitting leaning on the pillar, corner pillar. He was sitting, and I was just sitting lower step, one step lower than him. And he was trying to explain Advaita, and then my whole incompletion and constipation started. I know Advaita. Vibhudananda Puri told me, Yogananda Puri told me, Annamalai Swami Hill told, Virabhu Gita, all big, big books. Big, big literatures I read. And there's a big book called Atma Puranam. It's a Tamil translation of four major Upanishad. Aitreya Upanishad, Ishavasya Upanishad, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Four major Upanishad translation. Still the copy is with me, given to me by Isakki Swami. So I have read all those big, big books. But somehow never became reality, so that whole undigested incompletion. So the moment Arunagirishwara saw in my eyes the kind of a non-interest, sleepy, mood, I know. He was looking into my eyes. I know he is reading me. He will be so deep, oh God. It is just such lovely, beautiful, sweet eyes. You can just dive into his eyes for ages and forever. Never to return back. Come out of it. Such an expressive, vast eyes like an ocean. And his eyes had an amazing, it is like a pacific and pacifying both. The depth like pacific and compassion like pacifying. It can pacify anything. So available on the surface and so deep in the being, using that powerful eyes, he was looking into me. Of course, that is too much. So naturally, sleep disappears. I'll describe the scene. The next word is Sami. That's the way he used to call me, because that is the way my whole family used to address. I had hundreds of names given and self given, and it continues even now. But most used name is this Swami. Even my mother used to call me as Swami only. From the time I remember me, I never heard any other word from my mother. Even as a baby, as a child, I always heard only she calling me, addressing me as a Swami. Never I have heard from her the name my parents have given. It's only Swami. So Arunagirishwara uttered the word Swami. The moment he called Swami, I just sat up, and the eye and eyes got locked his eyes and my eyes got locked. He raised the right hand with a gesture. Are you able to raise your hand? So the meaning is, are you able to do what you want? It was not verbal. It was like a show. So naturally, I responded. Means I moved my hand and showed, yes, I can. Suddenly, Onada. It just clicked and I started laughing. He started laughing. Laughing. Both of us were laughing for 10 minutes. Understand, I'll tell you exactly what happened in me. When you have a consciousness which can command and execute something that is one with ultimate, so you are ultimate. I know now with this theory there will be 100 questions, doubts you may have. All that we can digest, grind, burn, next. But the first click, he's right. That first click was so powerful. The words uttered were only two words. Sami. Then he showed through the gestures. Are you able to move the right hand? So I responded in the same way, gestures, not words. Yes, I can move. What is there? So just when this gesture question answer was going on, I could understand very clearly what he is trying to convey. If you have a consciousness which can command and make the matter, body is matter, make the matter obey, listen, you are carrying which is ultimate. You are the consciousness which is ultimate. Onada. Like something hit on my forehead. It was such an ecstasy blossoming, flowering. I started laughing and he started laughing. At least next 10 minutes. It's like I felt, oh God, took kadka pudi and cleaned up the whole constipation. And all the incompletion went away. Became complete. If you had constipation for 1 week and had kadka pudi and cleansed, came and lie down on the bed, how you feel? Exactly. Oh God. Yes. If I have something which has a power to will and command and make the matter obey, then I have a consciousness which is ultimate.
from that click started manifesting powerful cognitions. Hey, if this consciousness can move these hands, why not the air next to the hands? Why not the stone next to the air? Why not the hill next to the stone? The powerful cognitions have started manifesting. And the powerful cognitions have brought understanding, knowledge, powers, all rooted, centered on this one click. Listen, I can only reenact. I cannot tell what happened. I can only reenact. He showed the gesture like a, are you able to move your hands? That's exactly. In my inner space, I can immediately understand the gesture and respond. Why not? See? In this interaction itself, my mind is searching, what is he trying to teach through this interaction? What is he trying to insert into me by this gesture? I started looking for, yes, he is asking, can you move your hand? And I am saying, yes, I can. What is the problem? What is he trying to convey through this? I can see very clearly the next understanding coming to me. Eh? So, commanding, and the commanded is obeying, the will is acting on the matter, being established in the consciousness, then what? I was looking into his eyes. I can still remember that casual, sweet, most simple way of giving initiation into the most complicated truth, Advaita. That twinkle in the eyes. Onada. Means, he said in Tamil, it's one. It is same. Understand. Now the punchline. Listen. If there is a will established in consciousness which can move the matter, your hands are matter, the body is matter. If there is something which is you, which can give a command to move this matter and this matter moves, the ultimate is in you. It can tell, command, order any matter to move. Understand? The moment you decide, it can command any matter to move, manifesting shaktis starts. I am telling it is not moving is inauthenticity, powerless cognitions, the conclusions before even you try. Have you told this board to move and it did not move? If that is the case, you have not told to the board in which the way in which the board can listen. So change the method of telling till the board listens, not doubt the technology of Advaita, which is the source. You always do the stupidity of doubting the technology without applying it. Understand? Guru Bhakti is a strength to make you apply the technology, update the technology without doubting the original science. Fortunately, I had that kind of a bhakti with Arunagiri Yogeshwara. So immediately when powerful cognition started manifesting in me, he said, right, if I can move this hand, I can move the air next to the hand. If I can move the air next to the hand, I can move the stone next to the air. If I can move the stone next to the air, I can move the hill next to the stone. I just need to find a method of conveying my command to it. To the hand, my command is passed through the nerves. So I have to pass my command to the air. Air bending is possible if I know how to do my mind bending. So, just like I sent my command to my hands, I should send my command to the air. I should send my command to the stone. I should send my command to the hill. My cognitions have started moving in that direction. Instead of, oh, I tried yesterday itself 2 times to move the article and it did not move. So I don't think Advaita is. No. Fortunately, my inner space did not move in that direction. Listen. Essence of today's satsang. Swami, onnada. Listen. It is too small incident. But the first sword of Advaita fell on me. Cut across through my being and started releasing powerful cognitions. I think in this whole incident, that intimacy matters. That space matters. The ability to get locked into the eyes matters. Where master is trying to convey something through the gestures and you catch that and it unravels itself in you and you respond same way in the gestures without answering and he captures and just throws one word, onada. And it just hits you like a thunderbolt and you start laughing. Hey! That laughter, my laughter and his laughter, during that laughter itself, I am giving command to the air to move and air is moving. I can see in that ecstasy laughter, I am giving command to the matter around me and it is responding.
Then starts power manifestation on the planet Earth after centuries. This is exactly, precisely power manifestation initiation I received from Arunagiri Yogeshwara. This is exactly the fundamental foundation thought current or the cognition which clicked with me and the power manifestation has started. After that, we sat for many hours, many days. He was helping me, supporting me to play with various elements. Then he explained tattva, all the 36 tattvas, and how when you give command to your biceps, the any principle which is parallel, using your eyes, seeing the scene in front of you, and using the third eye, seeing the scene somewhere happening, and say at the same time cognizing both, and getting that information and sharing with the person who is sitting in front of you, is what is parallel action. Understand, you see what is going on remote through third eye, come back and share it to the person who is in the front. It means you are cognizing this and that simultaneously. All parallel command is given to your biceps. Soon I'll prove all this with medical researchers and scientific researchers. Whenever you go through the remote vision, your biceps will be very active. Whenever you play with nature, like bringing rain, this time on World Environment Day, we will be bringing rain in 108 places, all 108 places. We will declare the places and successfully bring rain. You will see. Not 107, 108. All 108. On June 5th, World Environment Day, we will connect with nature and bring rain. Whenever you play with nature, your shoulder will be active. So later on, he taught me all these sciences of 36 tattvas. And whenever you command and work with the sun, your right eye will be very active. And whenever you work with chandra, moon, your left eye will be active. When you work with fire, agni samyama, or trying to blow fire and all, the third eye will be active. And these are the subtle principles of tattvas he taught later. That is different. The manifesting powers itself started with this click. With this. Meditate on this one. What I said today. On this one cognition. On this one initiation Arunagiri Yogeshwara gave me.
all the other powerful cognitions opening up, everything we will do next. But this is the source of manifesting powers. So this is the Mahavagya for manifesting powers. Sami Onnada. And then 10 minutes of, at least 10 minutes of uproarious rolling laughter. I was just pulling his dhoti and shaking his hands, because it was such big clarity. It is like I heard enough of Advaita, but never it clicked as a cognition out of which I can function, understand? Only when something becomes cognition out of which you can function, that becomes life for you. Not otherwise. Not otherwise. Whether it is a love or hatred, anger or compassion, fear or forgiveness, only when it becomes your cognition out of which you can function, it becomes reality to you. Not otherwise. Not otherwise. I remember going to few universities in USA, UCLA, Berkeley, few universities. Not Berkeley, I think, UCLA. UCLA and University of Oklahoma once, one university in Oklahoma, and few universities. One very elderly senior scientist, he took me to dormitories of the senior professors and scientists. It was much worse than our dormitory. Whether the size or the cleanliness. I was shocked. These guys must be getting highly paid. Why are they living like this? He said, Swamiji, most of these big guys are bachelors or divorcees. They can't live with women. They can't live with the spouse. They don't want to maintain a house, so they pick up a dorm here or an apartment here, because they are so engrossed and their research became their cognition. They can't cognize anything else in their life. I asked him, they must be getting heavily paid. They said, Swamiji, all of them are millionaires. Some of them are even billionaires because they have patent rights. But they will not even know what is their net worth. Most of them just write a will to the university and die. And the whole thing goes to university. Till death, they don't even check what is their net worth. What becomes your cognition only is your reality. Listen, I'll repeat. What becomes your cognition only is your reality. Even if they have money, it has not become their cognition, so it has not become their reality. Their reality is something else. Same way, I heard so much about Advaita, but it never became my reality. This one initiation. Onnada. Suddenly, it clicked so beautifully, so thoroughly. Only now I can understand how in the Svetasvara Upanishad, just Guru utters Tattvamasi Svedaketu Tattvamasi and immediately Svedaketu realizes. Only after I experienced I can catch yes.
Otherwise so many gurus utter Tattvamasi so many thousands of times to so many thousands of disciples.
Then what next?
In Bengal there is a funny proverb. In Sadhu Bandara, Sannyasi's Bandara, the Mahant will announce,
Brahmasatyam Jagatmitya. Brahmasatyam Jagatmitya means God alone is real, existence only is real, the world is illusory. The sadhus who are sitting in the row for eating, they will say kavar pore after eating all this. Brahmasatyam Jagatmitya kavar pore after eating, not now. World is illusion after we finish eating, not before eating. Means it has not become cognition. Brahmasatyam Jagatmitya, when? After we finish serve the bandara. Not before Rasagulla. After Rasagulla. After Jalebi, after food, Brahmasatyam Jagatmitya. Not before. I should tell you. Precisely at that moment, something which did not click for me for years clicked. Meditate on this today. I bless you. All of you will manifest powers. Today manifesting powers from this initiation, from this source. Essence of today's satsang, Swami Unnada. Understand. See, you need to understand the click happened in me. See, I know he also gives command, and not only his hands, he can move much beyond. So I also can give command. As of now my hands are moving. Maybe quantity of his ability to move and quantity of my ability to move may be different, but the quality is not different. If the quality is not different, that's all matters. Onnada. Quantity does not matter. It will come by itself by the more and more powerful cognitions. It is quality that matters. So when he said Onnada, means it is same. The multiple levels of click happened. Like the sword fell on my being, cut all the grandis, knots, incompletions. Kids, if you give a thread ball to them, they will always make a big knot. Trying to pull this side and that side, it will become knot. So what is the way to cut the knot? The only way is to cut it completely. Only then all the knots will be cleared. Same way with too many advaitic confusing corrupt cognitions from so many people, it has become not in my anandaganda, like a chitjada grandhi. This whole thing, onada, like a sword fell on that chitjada grandhi and broke the whole thing. So now, in quality one, then quantity does not matter. That naturally follows. When that powerful cognition landed, more and more powerful cognitions are more and more manifesting powers. That's all. Sami, onnada.
I welcome all of you for this Shiva Tattva and Vidya Tattva session. Let's invoke Mahadeva's presence, Mahasadashiva's presence. Let him bless all of us and allow us to understand him in us, us in him. Things I'm going to talk are too strong. Till now whatever you heard, if it is one unit confusing, this will be 1,000 unit. Not actually confusing, I should say the too strong understanding, and you seeing me is very important. Lot of Sami Onnada moment will be happening, so you seeing me is very important. See, one thing all of you understand, I'm initiating you into deep understandings and powers. It'll all click when you start living more and more. It'll be like a digestion. Every time, every day you take bath, while you are under shower, suddenly something will click. While you are going for two, something will click. While you are brushing your teeth, something will click. How many of you are constantly seeing now? Nowadays, whole day something is clicking. Because I am injecting you guys with intense energy. See, it needs certain kind of a muhurta to be developed. Muhurta means where you and me are in a friendly meeting space where things can be told as it is, where the deeper understanding can happen, where Amrita Kala can be transmitted. See, I have spoken only about 5 dimensions. Length, breadth, depth, time, space. I have not spoken on all the 11. Now I am going to speak on all the 11. Understand, all the length, breadth, depth, these are all different dimensions, different planes. Space in you and the space outside you where you are living and the whole space is actually one and the same. Your self-doubt, self-hatred, self-denial makes you feel they are separate and you are separate. Fortunately, your self-hatred is not more powerful than my ability to initiate you. That's a good news. See, fundamentally, Mahadeva
When he describes this Vidyapada and Shivatattva, Vidyatattva and Shivatattva, the whole chapter is called Vidyapada, Brihendragama. It is actually fourth part of Kamikagama, but this chapter is so independently intelligent, Mahadeva has given a separate title for this as Mahendragama. How many of you are able to cognize, even roughly, that space is one and the same? Chidakasha. Chidakasha is the space where you are living. Saharakasha, Chidakasha, and Mahakasha. I want all of you to know, if you have teleported 21 times consistently, the Akasha element has fallen in love with you and it is in tune with you. You are in oneness with Akasha and you don't have death. When you leave the body, you will not lose memory. The moment Akasha element, you have oneness with Akasha element, no more death fear. I am going to introduce Mahasadashiva. All his aspects and dimensions, even if you don't intellectually catch it, it's okay. Just sit. At least let your intellect knows he is beyond your intellect. Even that is also in a way catching it. Knowing that you can't know it also is in a way knowing it. So you can see Mahasadashiva's, the way he describes himself in Agama with Adi Shakti, you can see him with 25 heads. I should say, head without third eye is head. The moment third eye is awakened, it is no more head, it is identity. Head becomes identity when third eye is awakened. Till your third eye is awakened, even if your head is cut, no use. Nothing is lost. Because nothing worthy is there in the head. Once the third eye awakens only, you become an identity. So, because your existence is needed. Your existence is needed for you, for society, for humanity, for the universe. Till third eye is awakened, your existence is nothing more than this animals in the slaughterhouse. People look at that only as a next day meal. It's not looked as a animal. Of course, that is not right. That is next. So you can see him having 25 heads. First layer 9, second layer 7, third layer 5, fourth layer 3, last layer 1. Listen, actually this 25 is not number 25. It is just countless. Any identity is part of Mahasadashiva. Then it is zillion or zillions and zillions. It's countless. I'll explain, then you'll understand. Please see this. Below, the 9 heads, they represent unit dimensions of the cosmos, like a length, breadth, depth, time, space, The unit dimension. The other four, don't worry about it now. I'll explain later. Let me give you understanding step by step so you understand it is your own head. Listen. The lowest rung, that lowest line, represents length, breadth, depth. Why I want you to understand, you know, by understanding it, you will understand you also have all this in you. Some of your heads are not awakened, that's all. You also have all this. Most of you are awakened only with the first head. That's why only one head length, that's all. That's all, you know. In this length and in this length. For all greed, for all fear, over. You know only length. Listen, first unit, length, all of you understand, your logic. Breath, your visualization, our emotion, heart. Understand, as long as there is only length and breath, only these two exist. But when the length and breath gets matured to depth, not only depth is born, in depth there are many other things born. Listen, when there is a water and land, these two are separate two units. When the water and land gets mixed, not only the fertile land is born, in the fertile land multiple things are born. How many of you are catching it? That multiple things in depth, when the length and breadth operates, the first thing starts is Shabda. Shabda. In depth, length and breadth crisscrossing. Your visualization and your logic crisscrossing. In depth, manifests Shabda. Like one man, one woman becoming husband and wife and living in a home creates Shabda. Man is length, woman is breadth, house is depth. It is not just length, breadth, depth. Now the side effect starts. So that is why from the head of the depth, the multi-dimension starts. The next second layer is not called second layer, multi-dimension. Listen, because in that Shabda head, it is not one head, it is inclusion of length, breadth, depth together. So how many heads? So four put together is represented by one identity. Length, breadth, depth. All these are unit dimension. It is called Tattva. Unit. Listen carefully. Just now you all understood this Shabda head. This head. All of you are able to see the Shabda head. That is four in one. Am I right? Which is not. Listen carefully. To give you the first initial understanding, I told that is four in one. Now listen. Length is one, breadth is length, breadth plus breadth two. Then depth is length one, breadth two, depth three. So how many? When the depth is six, how can Shabda be just seven? How many of you are understanding? Listen. So now, one length, two breadth, three depth put together goes into multi-dimension. So it is not four. It's how many? Let's calculate. Length one, breadth two. So how many it becomes now? Plus 3 of the depth. So then 6 plus the one shabda, the which is outcome of the six. So how many? Shabda is not one. Shabda is how many? Seven. Listen. Seven plus this three plus this two plus this one. How many of you are getting? So what is the shabda number? When you look no, 13. When you look superficially, how it looked? No, first four. One layer depth. When you look, how it looked? Seven. One more layer depth. When you looked only, where it is coming? So the shabda head is not seven. You see how it describes, you know. When you look in the front, nine faces appear. When you look in the side, again nine faces appear. When you look in the back, nine appears. When you look this side, nine appears. Then it is round, round pyramid structure. Nine, any side if you see nine, it does not mean one layer has only nine. Understand? Come with me. In this calculation, I am teaching you depth. How universe multiplies. How life is multiplying. Shabda. Tell me now. Length is one. Length one. Breadth two. Depth three. So in depth, how many heads are there? So now, this gets into shabda, where shabda, when it is, see, till your child is born, he is part of both of you. The moment he is born, he is one independent entity. The moment shabda is born, he is independent entity having wall. Length 1, breadth 2, depth 3 as part of him. Because he has become independent, he himself has one more length, one more breadth, one more depth. Everyone is catching? So it is not plus, it is multi. Universe is multidimensional, not universe. The word is itself is too small. Multiverse is the right word. Now, when time is added to the length, breadth, depth, the next dimension, next unit is time. But understanding this in your cognition is very important. Time, when it is added, time is not fourth head, four head together, which is not four, which is one, plus two, plus three, plus four. Because time is born now, it is four. Now, when the time and shabda gathers, forms nada. Nada means defined sound. If the time, with the time, when it forms rhythmically, it is called nada. Shabda is wild sound. Nada is language. You understand the difference? Shabda is wild sound. Nada is language. Shabda is wild river. Nada is embanked canal. Nada kala is pure drinking water. I'll explain about that next. It is in nada kala your will is created. Understand, your will does not belong to a language. Sometimes even what you don't describe will become reality because it belongs to intelligence. See, when you create a will to manifest power, your wordings will never be adequate. How many of you understood that? The word you generate for manifesting powers, your will, the words you generate will never be adequate instruction. It will be like a legal document only. Unsaid, unforeseen, foreseen, unforeseen. A person who can bring integrity to his thought current only can experience nada kala. Means while you are thinking, completion. Listen carefully. Listen. While you are making a will to manifest power, if you are not comfortable and complete enough about the instruction you generated, and you are feeling very unstable, little incomplete, I don't know whether I did it right and am I completely creating the word. All this, how many of you are having? That is what is non-integrity with yourself. That is why insistence on integrity. You understand, integrity is not morality. It is a spiritual power. Ability to make a clear will. Hey, this is it. Leadership, integrity is one and the same. Chastity and integrity is one and the same. Listen now. I am not asking you to practice integrity as a morality. I am asking you to practice integrity to define your nada to nada kala. Means subtle purification in your thinking. Subtle purification in your thinking makes your whole body ecstatic. Listen, there is a beautiful story. Somebody goes to this great Swami Brahmananda, who is literally considered to be son of Sri Ramakrishna. In Ramakrishna mission, Swami Brahmananda has a higher place than Vivekananda. If you are an insider, you will understand. Brahmananda is considered to be the spiritual son of Ramakrishna. This Brahmananda Swami, somebody goes to him and asks, I want sannyas, I want to be brahmachari and sannyasi. He was actually sitting and peeling that potato, Bengalis, potato and sugar. Even if they want to commit suicide, they will add that in the poison and drink. Bengalis, even if they want to commit suicide, they will add potato and sugar in that poison and drink. Only then they will commit suicide. If you are any, there is any Bengali, don't feel offended. So he was peeling the potato. Mach Mishti Tamak, that is their life. He gave the potato to that boy, young man, and asked him peel. That guy was shocked. I came for sannyas and he is giving me the potato and asking me to peel. He peeled one potato and the Brahmananda Swami took the potato and said, you will not be a sannyasi, get lost. I won't admit you in the monastery. No admission, rejected, get lost. He says this only. The subtle clarity in thinking, a level of integrity is required for chastity. Sometimes my administrators who work around me, I'll tell them, the person would have done a mistake in accounts department, I'll say, she is not chaste, he is not A brahmachari, there is a hole in the pot. He cannot be sannyasi. They will think, how can I make such a big observation for some 30 rupee, 40 rupee accounts missing? It is not what has happened, it is from where it has happened. The Nada Kala. Understand, this whole detoxification is to raise your Shabda to Nada, Nada to Nada Kala. To bring you more and more integrated to your thinking. That's all, nothing else. What you want, if you can tell yourself, you can get it because you are Mahadeva. Understand? Length 1, breath 3. How many of you are understanding? It's not 2, it is 1 plus this one, 3. Depth 1 plus 3 plus what? 3. 1 plus 3 plus 3, 7. Because the moment depth is born, that is 3. The moment child is born, you can't keep him as you want. Because he is born out of you does not mean he will be under you. You always have this stupid thing, equating him also as equivalent to you. No, he is both of you put together and his own craziness. You never value his craziness. Understand? That is why you are shocked when you see his craziness. So now, what about time? Ayyo, you yourself calculate. 1 plus 3 plus 7. So what is the number? 11 plus 11. Because the moment time is born, it has all the identities of this 11 into it. Not even 11, 12. Because time is its own independent identity. How many of you are catching? What is space now? No, actually you will have to visualize clearly. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and count. By the time coffee has come to mind, no, come back. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. I am not confusing. I am making you guys understand the futility of your mathematical length. I am just making you guys move to the next level. How many of you are catching what I am saying? It is not pyramid structure, it is living identity structure. See, again it is gone. Tell me like, now you are in the time zone. What all you can experience? The very depth of the time. Lengths, all the things. Breaths, length and breaths. Depths, length and breaths and depths. Lengths, breaths, depths and time in time. Listen, I am not confusing you, listen. Length of the length and length of the breath both exist in time. Length of the length and length of the breadth and length of the depth exists in time. I mean, if you are catching, because now time is born, the length of the time. I mean, if you are understanding, you may think, why should I know all this? Because, listen, even all this being informed to your depth, you will play with the powers very properly and you will know if at all you are stuck somewhere, where you are stuck, and you can just clear it. understand knowledge is power. Brahmavit brahmaiva bhavati, understanding Brahman, knowing Brahman, you become Brahman. Mahadeva says in one verse, if you just know what gender you belong to, you will simply become brahmachari or highest virile person, highest virya and brahmacharya, both need not be practiced. You just need to know which gender you are, that's all. All failure in brahmacharya or in celibacy is not knowing your gender, he says. Just you know your gender, you are brahmachari or the most virya person, powerful person. Any confusion, complexity, contradiction created due to sexual attitudes, attributes is just ignorance of which gender you belong to, that's all. Same way he says, any confusion with cosmos is nothing but ignorance, that's all, nothing else. If Mahadeva's 11 gender understanding is revealed to the world, whole so-called sexology and psychology will become irrelevant. That is a separate subject. Let's come back here. In time, what all exists? Lengths, length, breadths, length, depths, length, times, length. Breadths, breadth, depths, breadth, times, breadth, and depths, depth, and times, depth, and time, because it is born now. If you both have not produced a children, that is okay, child, that is okay, but once it is produced, it is an independent entity. Number three, understand, multiple things coordinating its existence in tune with the existence of everything is universe. The being which makes everything independently intelligent but continues to make them all operate as independent intelligence is Mahadeva. I'll repeat. Length is an independent intelligent. Breadth is an independent intelligent. Depth is independent intelligent. Time is independent intelligent, kala. But there is somebody who keeps all this as independent intelligent and moves them. Without interfering in the independent intelligence, coordinating beautifully without controlling, leading without bossing. By the innate intelligence, they all coordinate and exist. And be part of that ultimate independent intelligence. That being is Mahadeva. Understand? This is the unique truth revealed in Hindu scriptures. Neither personality nor just automated intelligence, automated independent intelligence, inseparable existing solid personal appearance. No, you have to catch it, no other way. I will sit, I'll make you sit, but you will have to catch it. Space, if you talk to space, it responds to you directly. That does not mean there is nobody higher than space. There is somebody leading, but not bossing. Who responds is innate part of the space and above space. Is embodied and above. Mahadeva is Kala Bhairava and above. Kala is Kala Bhairava, time. Mahadeva is Kala Bhairava and above. How many of you are getting it? What all is there in the space, shall we see? Lens length, breadth length, depth length, times length, and spaces length. Am I right? Then breadth's breadth, depth's breadth, times breadth, and spaces breadth. Am I right? Depth's depth, times depth, and spaces depth. Am I right? Now, what will be the number for space? Now, what about the space of the number of time? Times number and components number. Sorry, the spaces number and the components number. Because space is now independent entity, it has its own leaves allotted and its totality. Like your son sits for a dinner, he gets his plate and your plate and your wife's plate, because he represents both of you and he is also independent, so he gets his third plate. How many of you are understanding? That is precisely the way the multiple intelligences are operating in you. Now, how many of you understand this? God is one is the most stupid, silly conversation human being can ever have. It is more silly than any politician's speech. Politicians declaring they will bring peace. Understand? Not being afraid of multiple intelligence existence, consciously knowing that there is a coordination, it is not chaos, it is order in the whole chaos, brings tremendous restful awareness in you. There's an order. One of the biggest problem all of you have is, oh, when I make a will to have a health, I am doing it, it's manifesting. When I make a will to manifest even third eye reading, I am manifesting. When I make a will to manifest wealth, why I am not doing it? How many of you have this conflict? In some zone my will is manifesting, in some zone my will is not manifesting. Understand, the moment your will is manifesting in one zone, the order has started happening in you. Now it is only the question of healing happening in all the regions where you have committed the damages. If you can heal your headache, I guarantee you can raise your bank balance. If you can raise your bank balance, I guarantee you can just teleport anything from anywhere. You don't need to do shoplifting. No more need for any shoplifting. And nothing will be lifted from shop. It will be sourced from the air. So don't worry. See, if you resist even to understand these numbers, that is what is fear of chaos. You think everything is chaos. Anything I can't understand is chaos. Fear of unmanifest, avyakta. When I said shabda is four, everyone was very happy. Yes, one, two, three, four. And I said, no, it is not four. Now, fundamentally, I want you to know, breath is length, breath put together and its own independent existence. Understand? See, length, breath, is this going in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, in this direction? Fundamentally, what I am trying to convey, ability to increase the frequency of your existence, ability to be present without getting overwhelmed. Confusion is okay, overwhelming is okay, that is also part of your, one of your head, which is unmanifest. Your own head of logic is trying to grasp your unmanifest dimension. There exists confusion, which is not something away from you, as Mahasadashiva, all both exists in you. This length which is trying to understand, and the depth which is non-understandable, and the confusion generated which is avyakta, unmanifest, during this whole process. How many are understanding? Getting comfortable with your inner space, knowing it is too large to be judged by you. Even though he is sitting with Adi Shakti, he is the ultimate brahmachari, sannyasi. Even though he gave this whole agama, he is in eternal silence, mauna. Listen carefully. Can you guys understand this? Put the number for space. Then put the number for shabda. Then put the number for nada. And put the number for nada kala. And put the number for bindu. And put the number for bindu kala. And put the number for amrita kala. See, multi-dimension, multiple dimension. And Shakti dimension. The multi unit becomes multi, multi becomes multiple, multiple becomes so vibrant. It is no more a matter. It is just energy. In Amrita Kala, it is just infinity. How many of you are already feeling headache? Good. Few minutes. Shall we put the number? Come on, let me play with your length. Now after you put the number, I will reveal the fundamental secrets Mahadeva Israel telling. Every one of you try, because you see, trying makes you engaging. Understand, whether you are able to understand or grasp, it's okay. Engage with those words, engage with those understandings. Shall I just give you the fundamental unit explanation? You see, shabda is sound, wild sound, nada is organized language, nada kala is poetic music, rhythmic music. When the space is added, when the time is added to sound, it becomes language. When the space is added to the sound, it becomes music, or vibrant, alive, living manifestation. All the will is generated in nada kala and becomes reality. Then bindu means whatever you are seeing as reality in the front is bindu. Why? What is the energy that keeps this pillar in the shape of pillar is bindu. Bindu kala is purity of this, like a source of life, source of visualizations. Nada is verbalization, bindu is visualization, source of visualization, the cosmic visualization. Amrita kala is just eternal existence, which exists for ever and ever. Just existence, pure undying existence in all its beautiful glorified form. Let's see how many of you are going to use what all formulas to. This is called Shiva Vidya. Mahadeva describes this as Shiva Vidya Tattva. Okay? If you understand this only, you will become Shiva Vidya. How many of you finished? How many of you are still doing? How many of you understood it's not possible? And how many of you understood it's not possible and not doing? No question of not doing. Now listen to one line. How many of you think shabda is totality of length, breadth, depth. From that shabda appears. Listen. Yes. It appears from length, breadth, depth, no doubt. So you will put the totality of length, breadth, depth to shabda. But it cannot exist without space. That is why multi-dimension. Anything in multi-dimension may be generated from some of the unit dimension, but it cannot exist without all the unit dimensions cooperation. How many of you are getting? So all the unit dimensions have to be present in even the first of multi-dimension. Understand, I am teaching you the tattva, unit of the cosmos. Can sound, shabda, exist without space? In length, breadth, depth, it will be generated. But it will die the moment it is generated. Only if the space, it can hold it and keep it alive. Without space, can the sound be kept alive? Then, without space, the word I utter here, sound I utter here, it will die here. It will never reach your ears. It reaches your ears because there is a space. How many of you are understanding? So, multi-dimension means all the unit dimensions have to be present there. Multiple dimensions means all the unit dimension and multi-dimensions have to be present there. Now calculate. Now you are contemplating on Mahadeva and his glory. Understand? Only when your logic understands, it cannot capture. It allows the breath, emotion to open up, devotion to open up. When your devotion also understands, I cannot capture it. Your depth is, depth opens up. Your depth says, where am I to grasp him? Then your time opens up. Your time, when it goes crazy, the space opens up. The space only creates oneness. Listen, engaging with infinity is not to measure it, but to get disappeared, dissolved into it. So till you dissolve into it, you have to engage with it. You cannot say, oh, it is infinity, so I am sleeping. No. That is not, you have to calculate now. You have to engage with infinity. Oh, it is infinity. I came to conclusion I am sleeping is Vedanta. No. In Ahama, you engage with infinity. Each of you, the numbers you arrive, that many number of powers you are going to manifest. Then decide. Engaging with Mahadeva. He is proposing, will you become me? Understand, engaging with Mahadeva, engaging with infinity.
I'll continue to expand on Swami Onnada. See, you all understood. It just exploded in me. See, Birangi explodes the moment fire touches it. But before that, Birangi need to be prepared by filling gunpowder and compacting it. What is the gunpowder and what is the compacting process which makes the Birangi blast? You need to know that. There are thousands of gurus who repeat Tattvamasi, Svedagedo, Tattvamasi. But no Svedagedo becomes enlightened. Only one Svedagedo became enlightened. We need to know what was the gunpowder put inside me, what was the compacting process happened. So when he said, Sami, onnada,
it just exploded into reality. Understand?
If you actually hear this statement, Sami, onnada, it doesn't make any sense. Because much went on in sign language. Understand? I'm describing intimacy. Intimacy means ability to convey without communication, just through communion, not using words, verbalizations, but just by transmitting the visualizations through simple gestures and body language is intimacy. Understand? Communication may be intimate, but only communion can be intimacy. Intimate is different, intimacy is different. As long as words are required to transmit, an idea, it may be intimate conversation, but not intimacy. Only if the gesture is enough. See, gesture, transmitting the visualization can happen only when both are in tune. I should use the word at-one-ment, not even attuned. At one moment, when Arunagiri Yogeshwara called me, Sami, he just gestured through the eyes and the body. I'm describing frame by frame again. Means, are you able to move your hand? Immediately, my response is, why not? When I am moving my hand itself, my whole being is analyzing, what is he trying to convey through this question? So I am just studying as a pure witness. I can see very clearly, consciousness is the foundation on which the will is giving the command to move, and the matter, this body, moving. Understand? Immediately I could come to a very rough conclusion. Yes, it means he is trying to tell, you have consciousness which can use the will and move matter.
When I responded, why not? See, I'm moving.
Onnada. Just through the gesture, without using much word, I am also able to do that. You are also able to do that. Means, you and me are one and the same.
Like a powerful sword falling, this casual that sound onada. I can describe the frame, the eyelids very casually, slowly falling and shutting the eyes in a such a calm way with that utterance of onada, and then lifting off, looking at me with that tremendous curiosity whether I got it, whether it clicked with me. This side, these eyes have literally become like a camera and capturing the whole scene. With intense passion, eyes will stop blinking. That is why devatas who live in highest passion don't blink. Blinking is not the activity. Available in the body of the devatas. In the dasapranas, Dhananjaya is responsible for all pranas have a name. Like a prana, apana, utana, samana, vyana. Dhananjaya is one prana which is responsible for voluntary actions like eyelid closing itself often to moisturize the eyeballs. Whenever your attention is concentrated on your both eyes, the eyelids, the Dhananjaya prana is suspended. The kumbhaka happens with Dhananjaya prana. So, eyelids stop moving. Because Arjuna has mastered it, he is called Dhananjaya. Dhananjaya does not mean the who conquered the bow, who conquered the prana Dhananjaya. Because the prana Dhananjaya is recorded much, much ahead of Arjuna's time. Then prana named Dhananjaya is recorded, mentioned in Agamas itself. Arjuna's period is Itihasa. Because he conquered Dhananjaya, he is Dhananjaya. Not because he conquered the bow. Anyhow. I
I was so completely engrossed into him. When he uttered the word unnada, I could immediately catch it. Yes, consciousness which can operate will and move matter is ultimate. He also has that ultimate. I also have that ultimate. So naturally, as ultimate, we both are one and the same. As a quality, we are one and the same. When that clicks, you get the courage to make the quantity also one and the same. Understand, either you can be depressed, that quantity is not one and the same, how can it be one? Or you can become powerful when the quality is one and the same, why not make the quantity also happen? Either you can come to manifest the powerful cognition of when quality is one and the same, what quantity matters? It is just question of time and will persistence. Or you can say, quantity is not one and the same. What is there in quality being one and the same? And manifest powerless cognitions. What made me to choose the powerful cognition and tip this side is what I am calling gunpowder and compacting process. Understand? Gunpowder is, listen carefully, I think sit straight. We all know when you put the fire, biringi explodes. But before putting the fire, you need to put the gunpowder and compact it. Only then it can explode, not otherwise. When he uttered the word onnada, it is an explosion happened in me. You need to know what was the gunpowder and what was the compacting process. Listen carefully. Gunpowder is my love and integrity with Arunagiri Yogeshwara. Compacting process is Mannatha Sri Jagannatho Madguru Sri Jagadguru. Listen. Listen carefully. I'll give you a little raw example. But sometimes raw example only works. How much ever you hear about love, romance, sex, lust, and see the movies, TV serials, or pornography, how much ever you get informed, you enjoy it only through your spouse, husband or wife. So how much ever you hear about the Shastras, you experience only through your Guru. How much ever you may hear about
love, romance, lust, sex. Nowadays, literally by the age of 3-4, you start hearing about everything. Or the moment you start hearing, you start hearing. That is what is gunpowder getting added. Compacting is your decision to realize that what you heard. How much ever you may hear about love, romance, lust, sex, pleasure, build fantasies, visualizations, you can ultimately, finally enjoy, experience only through your spouse. The spouse is the door for experiencing all the pleasures, ideas, visualizations, fantasies you collected and built, created the pressure. Same way, whatever you heard about the ultimate God, He is everything. He is all-knowing, omnipresent, omnipotent, omnipowerful, akanda sachidananda, Sutta Swayam Prakasa, Nitya Paranjodi, Niramaya Nirahankara Nirguna. All these big concepts, visualizations, ideas, fantasies you hear about ultimate. All that input through the eyes, through the ears, everything about the ultimate. Finally, you can enjoy experience only through your guru. Understand, I might have heard about love, romance, physical pleasure, everything through thousands of sources, but I experienced, enjoyed only through you. That gratitude is chastity. To the spouse, that gratitude to the spouse is chastity. Same way, I might have heard about God, Brahman, universe, Advaita, Vishishta Advaita, Dvaita, all powerful, omnipotent, omnipresent, Akanda Paripurana Sachidananda, all big words, Niramaya Nirguna, Sutta, Sugamaya, Sugabodha. I might have heard about all those big theories, concepts, words, inputs, visualizations, fantasies about God, ultimate, everything. But finally, I realized it through my guru. This gratitude is called Guru Bhakti. Understand, that makes Mannatha Sri Jagannatho Madguru Sri Jagadguru. This clarity with Arunagiri Yogeshwara has settled inside me. Understand, for me, He is the symbol of ultimate everything I heard, I saw, I imagine every imagination I can have about God not only he was fulfilling, he was overdoing. Understand? I am not interested in talking to those stupid donkeys who say God cannot come in human form or he came only once, that is the last time. No. I am not interested in talking to them. Understand, if the principle God can come in human form, the best man who made to that cutoff, to that matching, to that description is Arunagiri Yogeshwara for me. Listen. Listening can add gunpowder in you and compact it. Simple listening. Like when you are involved with a movie, how you became the hero or heroine. When you listen to this story, you can become me. If the principle God can happen in human form is true, nobody can beat the perfection of Arunagiri Yogeshwara. This compacting of the gunpowder is required for the blast. Understand? Fortunately, I was not foolish. Okay, what is there? Even if I, me and Arunagiri Yogeshwara is one and the same, what is there? He and me are one and the same. Enough. Mannatha Sri Jagannatha. Madguru is Jagadguru. That compacting I should call chaste Guru Bhakti. If it can happen only through this door, I know. If not, the whole principle is wrong. Not the person in front of me. That becomes such clear. So crystal clear. That compacting was so perfect. The blasting could happen just by one gesture, Onoda. I want to put this on record. It is not that in that moment I became enlightened, but I should say the enlightenment started in me. Understand? It is not that that moment I became enlightened, but the initiation, the enlightenment has started in me. It has to start at some moment, na? Crackers got the fire. Gunpowder tasted the fire. Listen, integrity to Arunagiri Yogeshwara does not mean just doing what he is saying
For me, integrity with Arunagiri Yogeshwara means integrity to his very being. Understand? When he says he represents Sutta Chaitanya Sadashiva Shakti, that is what is for me as far as I am concerned. Understand? Integrity to his being. Fortunately, I did not think, oh, he also has two hands like me. He also has two legs like me. He also has body like me. Fortunately, I was in a society where the stupid, third-rate, dirty concepts neither existed nor was put in my ears. So I could enjoy his form so sweetly. The wedge which gets inserted into us by the society, disgracing and disconnecting us and our body, through wrong ideas, understandings about body and sex. Because of that wrong ideas, the separation of right and wrong, higher and lower, good and bad, that guilt, that same thing is projected on what is universal right and wrong, good and bad. The ripple effects and repercussions of the ripple effects. All that was absent, oh God. Thanks to Thiruvannamalai society in those days. It was such perfect setting. Such a sweet, such a beautiful ambience. Right place, right person, right understanding, and right experience. Listen. Unfortunately, society's corruption has entered. And removed that very possibility of that space. Forget about that. Let me describe. At least put it on record. For the humanity to know what was the gunpowder and what was the compacting process. Fortunately, I did not think like I have two hand, two leg, body he also has. How can he be ultimate? No. When you are in love, you manifest only powerful cognitions about that person. That is why everybody loves being in love. When you are in love, you manifest only powerful cognitions about that person. Fortunately, he has given me the greatest gift called Guru Bhakti. I was literally in love with him. So the powerful cognitions I was manifesting constantly about him. Made me cognize so strongly Manada Sri Jagannatho Madguru Sri Jagadguru. My Lord is Lord of the Universe. My Guru is Guru of the Universe. That established, cognized integrity, not just actions with him, but to his very introduction about him. Understand? What he introduced about him is my cognition about him. There is no gap between the two. There is no idea, oh, maybe he is telling 10 things about him. I think 4 things are right and remaining 6 I will check out. Fortunately, did not. Worst torture can happen to a man is not being endowed with bhakti. Not being endowed with the bhakti is the worst hell a human being can suffer. I tell you. Sadashiva hears about this Tripurasuras. Tripurasuras were a great devotee of Sadashiva. All three of them were sons of Tarakasura. Even when Tarakasura went against Sadashiva, these three said, no, we are Shiva devotees and we are not going to move away from Shiva. Such staunch fellows. But unfortunately, they had one uncle. This uncle fellow goes and corrupts them and awakens the Rakshasa DNA in them and says, hey, you guys are demons. Come on, let's enjoy. Come on, this is our lifestyle. This is our standard. Tantadai. And this uncle goes and corrupts them and through the peer pressure, he makes them do all the non-integrity things. So the devatas go and cry. See these Tripurasuras, your devotees, empowered by you with so much of powers, are misaligned to the cosmic dharma and disturbing the flow of the cosmic dharma. Nobody can touch them. Because you empowered them, what to do? Something has to be done. They have to be destroyed now. Simple. Sadashiva looks at Narada and tells, go and talk to that uncle who spoiled them. To take the next step, just remove Shiva Bhakti. Over. That's it. Narada does all this job very well. He goes and tells the uncle, hey, you have done such an amazing job of moving them out of. They are almost becoming devatas. You should retain your identity. Wow, now you almost made the whole thing. Pakka Asuraloka. And why unnecessarily this big Shivalinga and temples?
Shivabhakti is not the identity, or it's not fitting with this whole Asuraloka setup. It's something out of place. That uncle fellow, don't worry, I'll manage. I'll manage, don't worry. So he made sure next few days the drunk time was expanded little more, and few days your puja is broken. Understand, bhakti need to be practiced till the oneness manifests completely. Listen carefully. Actions which invokes sacred sentiments has to be repeated till those sentiments become your very cognition. Just few days. Shaktipada is disconnected. That is enough for them to lose the Shiva Bhakti. And all it takes is just few months. Few months, if you don't do puja, you will even forget you took Sivadiksha, Vishesh Diksha. It'll all become just old, good memories. Okay. Those days I used to be very active and overactive, I think. Just removing the Shiva Bhakti is enough. They were completely destroyed. Understand, seeing Arunagiri Yogeshwara as the symbol of ultimate. He is ultimate, that is different. Seeing him as the ultimate was the gunpowder. Integrity to him was the compacting process. So just one word, initiation, that fire, onada. The initiation exploded. Understand, whether doubt or faith, anything cognized becomes reality in your life. Whether doubt or faith, cognized becomes reality in your life. Reality is not based on what is, but what is perceived or cognized. I cognized is ultimate, he became ultimate to me. And I became ultimate. Manifesting the powerful cognitions even your decision to manifest powerful cognitions, because I decided, he supported. Even if you decide, you will be supported. It is not that you need to be already having that integrity and that gunpowder and compacting. It is not that already it is required. But even if you decide, I will have it. You will have that gunpowder uncompacting process. It is the pressure with which the gunpowder was compacted, that decides the power of the blast. That is why still I am singing that blast, and it is still blasting in all of you when I sing. அங்கையர் பங்கன் அங்கம் அசைத்து உன்னடா என்று சொல்ல என்னுள் நடந்ததை என்னடா வென்று வியப்பேனோ விரிப்பேனோ உரைப்பேனோ உழப்பேனோ. அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், இன்டெகிரிட்டி is not related to your action being in tune with as I want. It is very low level. It is your being in tune with who I am. It is your being cognizing who I am. Actually, the next moment, what happened in me, it was such laughter. I was literally pulling his dhoti and holding his hand and shaking. Those days, we do not know this hi-fi. We only know the village way of hi-fi is that pulling the hand and shaking. Laughing, laughing, laughing. Almost 10 minutes, I was laughing, he was laughing. During that laughter itself, I already started manifesting, saying, yes. If I can manifest moving this body through the will, why not the air next to the hand? And it started moving. Along with the mind bending, the air bending started. When it started, in the joy, ecstasy, that science is success, that initiation is success, I held his hand and started shaking and screamed, Swami. That is the essence of today's satsang. Essence of today's satsang, Swami, from my side. Essence of yesterday's satsang, Swami, unnada, from his side. Essence of today's satsang, Swami, from my side. I bless you all. Today all of you will have manifesting powers, and manifest powers. I will listen the ecstatic screaming from all of you, Swami. Even if you hear about the Miss Universe, Mr. Universe,
the experience is going to be only through your spouse. So even if you hear about ultimate or supra ultimate, it is going to happen only through your guru. That is guru bhakti. That is the chastity. And that leads to the ecstatic response of Swami. So let the manifesting powers continue today. I bless all of you, will manifest powers and have that ecstatic screaming, Swami. Let's all radiate integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Shaivam, Sadashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.